You know, I understand when I was, like, playing games like Three Houses as my first Fire Emblem, and, like, doing the maps somewhat legit, killing everything is, like, fun. You know what I mean? And I really enjoy doing that in Three Houses. And I enjoy it in this game, too. But fuck me, it's a lot harder. You know what I mean? Chapter 20 was one of the hardest maps to kill everything. We killed all the reinforcements. I had to create a +7 Rider's Bane just to kill those motherfuckers. It cost me a lot of money, but I wanted to kill them. But the only way we could even kill them is by setting up Geosphere crits, which is no nice. At least in Three Houses, if we're going to kill something, everything on the map, we actually can do it. Naturally. But in this game, we can't. So, like, those kind of reinforcements tell you that you're not supposed to kill everything in this level. You're not supposed to kill all these enemies. They're here to fuck you up. Accept it and move on. And I was like, I'm not accepting it. I'm killing these motherfuckers no matter what. But, like, yeah, it's completely different, that's all, you know? Like, it makes you not want to do... Look at all this nasty shit! You know, like, there's no way we can beat this! Without somebody fucking dying. You know what I mean? So no, it's just like, you take one look at these older Fire Emblem games' last maps and you're like, I really don't even want to fucking do it. If there's a one turn way, I'm gonna take it. You know, because that's how it feels. You know? Anyway, there is a one turn way. Because I said this is the only map that I looked into. Basically, our main guy had to have 12 move here or some shit. He didn't have, anyone could have the 12 move, but it's better to go on him. Him having the 12 move is like, it allows him to literally run up and save. If he only had the 10, he wouldn't be able to get here. You know? Basically, Sirius, he's on a horse in this level, or a flying mount, whatever. We'll have to go up here, we dance him, he can reach her. He reaches Nina, or whatever. We pass her a rescue staff. Our four-use rescue staff. She rescues... You know, we pass the rescue staff around like nonsense, you know. We also have to give somebody a bloody recover staff and shit like that. And then basically we go in with Marth, and then we again twice, and we get to kill him. On Lunatic Reverse, it's different, though, because if he hits us first... Say we hit the guy. Because he hits us first on Lunatic Reverse, you actually have to have a bit more setup here. We only need to heal twice. You get what I mean? No, we only need to heal once, because we go in with a hit, we heal. We go in with a hit again, we get hit. Then we go in with a hit, we're killing him on the third hit. You get what I mean? So we only need to heal him once. But on Lunatic Reverse, we have to heal him a bit more, which is why people come in with another 3 bishops with Physic. And that's how they do it on Lunatic Reverse, you know what I mean? I still think it's a bit much that they wanted you to bring in these units. If I'm being honest, that they wanted you to bring in... Fine with Minerva, because, like, you kind of want to use her here and there, but... Julian? What, a level 30 thief? I mean, I wouldn't think he's bad. I think he'd probably be alright at level 30. Imagine having all that speed and strength and doubling with Worm Slayers, but... I just didn't think it's realistic for somebody to be like, I want a capped... You know what I mean? Yeah. I mean, I'm fine with the Sirius and all that, but it's really Julian that I have a fucking problem with, to be honest. Sirius has been my mate throughout the whole game, though. You know? But he's just credible. That's his downfall. To be honest, though, everyone gets credit in the end game, dude. It feels like. I think this is all we're needing. Wait just a fucking minute here. Can she no use recover? Oh, we've done the wrong fucking bishop. Righto. Okay, dude. Alright. Yes, right, okay then. I never even considered that, but now I guess I should. We need someone with a B rank to be the one healing here. Okay. Because we need to recover him, you know what I mean? That's cool, dude. It's fucked up, though. Fuck's sake. Fucking hell, dude. Okay, so... so, like... let me have a look at... Who should we rescue first? I feel like we were doing okay until that fucking weird bit, you know what I mean? I feel like this part's right though. Yeah, okay, we're okay now. Had to fuck me over with a fucking staff rank, didn't you?
I did.
I respect it. No, really, though. It's fucking lame. We need one credit out of three. Alright. Man, fuck that guy. You know? Oh yeah, boy. Fuck this boss, you know? That's a GG right there, game. Oh yeah. I'm very satisfied. Does it? So what, we would win no matter what then? Alright. Yeah, I knew that. See, on Lunatic Reverse, we'd need about like three priests to heal him up to full kind of thing. Which wouldn't be bad if you knew. It's still an easy level even on Reverse. Came with the one turn, I mean. Very satisfied. That is Lunatic beaten, blind, well, apart from the past level. And I'm happy. No rainbow pee. You know what I mean? Natural. No scum and level ups. No, what's that thing? How's everybody doing? So, I feel like we've done it as legit as possible. And I don't think you can get any legit than no even knowing the game. You know what I mean? So, I'm pretty happy with that. Let's watch this. I want to see my rank. I bet you it's trash. Which is fine with me. No, I wasn't even going for rank. But, like, I'd like to see if it's, like, average. You know what I mean? An average rank or something. There was ups and downs in this playthrough, you know? Stress, chill. Definitely my favourite Fire Emblem game though. Yeah, I think I did recruit everybody. So... We Ryan. Quite like that, Yumina. Would maybe use her and, you know. No Yubella though. Barst. Here till the end, like. Yeah, I would imagine she is, yeah. It's a shame he is actually shipped away, because it would be alright to use Yubella. And quite liked him, but, you know, the 6 damage was killing it. That's fucked up, actually. I wouldn't mind using Ryan in Lunatic Reverse. Make him a horseman. You know? Better growth as a horseman anyway. George. I'll be using Etzo on Lunatic Loony Bin Reverse, I think. You know, I never even knew he was in Shadow Dragon, because it's a bloody guiding chapter, and people have to die to get them. I don't agree with the guiding chapters and fucking... You miss half the game. Can't wait to come back to this game and do Loony Bin Reverse, you know? If there is another next one I'm doing, though, it's going to be Conquest Lunatic. But I think we'll chill out until the Three Houses DLC is out, and I'm going to play that next. I think it's the 12th of February, so it's actually only a week away. And I'm up for going back to that and checking it out. Then after we're done with that, because I didn't intend on playing it over and over and over again, because I've played Three Houses so much, I really don't think this DLC is going to be all that. I think it'll be, like, cool for, like, several hours as a side story thing. but I don't think it's going to incorporate much new shit into the game. Even though it's got new classes and stuff, I can't see the DLC for Three Houses expanding it up so much that it just makes me want to play it another 5 times in a row. You know, I can't see that. I hope so, though, but it's like a side story, and we have to, like, choose the side story for the title menu, so. But I think what that does is unlock the new people in the main story. But even then, the main story is no any different. You get what I mean? I was actually hoping we would have a prequel story regarding Sothis, Nemesis, playing as Geralt when he was younger and stuff. Something that actually made sense. No, just these dudes living in the Abyss basement. I don't know, it's a wee bit underwhelming, but, you know, a lot of people seem happy with it. I was really hoping for a prequel Nemesis Sothis thing, you know? But we're not getting that. We're just getting another house in the main story thing. I don't know. I don't like Midia. I'll tell you that right now. Because every level she's on is a pain in the fucking ass. Do you know what I mean? I think. You know, she's in that one on Shadow Dragon where all the dudes are lining her up in the cell trying to kill them all. You need to get up there as quick as fucking possible to save them. And then in this one, she's in bloody Harden's level. Ugh. And that's like one of my worst levels because I killed all the reinforcements. You know what I mean? Yeah, well, like we talked about before, that's why the mid game's so easy in Fire Emblems, you know. Assuming that people have died is all the developers can do, and then the end game picks it back up again, you know. Because they can't make the mid game solid when you've lost 10 units and they give you new ones with shit bases. You know, it's. She wasn't in much of this game, eh? Nina and... It's a good job she had a B staff rank, by the way. Just saying. I actually really like the story of these ones. Do you know what I mean? I actually say it's one of the more Fire Emblem games beside Three Houses that grabbed my attention in the story. With Shadow Dragon and us combined. You know what I mean? It's just like fighting with Harden and Wood, Wolf and Sedgar and Astrum and George and all that. In the first game, we're all pals and shit. And then in this game, because Harden's been corrupted and shit, we're all fighting each other and, like, the Wolf Guard's on. You know, it's all kicking off. And it's got the emotions going with the story. I honestly feel like it's one of the only... could honestly say that the GBA Fire Emblem games didn't really make me give two shiny shits about the story. But then... you know, it was like Shadow Dragon and this game combined have actual something going on to make you care. You know what I mean? And like every person you see is like, whoa, it's that guy, it's this, you know. It's got that going on for it, as well as the awesome gameplay. I mean, that's why it's my favourite one, I'm telling you. As far as I've heard, Conquest is, it's all about gameplay because the story's whack. So, you know, what can you do? I think that's why it's such a shame that this one's never truly been released in the West. 10 years and it's never been released in the West. Honestly, I can't believe it. You know what I mean? Can't believe it. That we're not supposed to even be playing this. And it's like the best one. You know? There was some cool things about 8, though, but there's some bad things. I don't like the grinding that the game wants you to do. And, like, a lot of people say that it's, like, optional, which it is. But still, it doesn't feel optional, because the game just wants you to grind. You literally have to run away from battle if you don't want to grind. That's not optional, as far as I'm concerned. And everybody who says it is just straight up wrong. And doesn't care about gameplay. They just care about grinding. And that's fine. But you need to think about the other half of the fan base too. Who do like the gameplay. And do like the challenge. Rather than just grinding. You know what I mean? It's fucking silly. That's why our Sacred Stones is so cherished by a lot of people, because it just lets you do what you want in that regard. But it fails as a Fire Emblem game because of it. And most people who like the gameplay understand that. A lot of people who don't understand the gameplay will never understand that, because they play on normal mode. And that's it. And we have to respect both sides. Nobody's right or wrong in that regard, because that's just the way it is. You know? I've never had a problem with money in Fire Emblem games, though, I'll be honest. In Three Houses, I suffer from a bit of a money problem early on, and that's because I get reasonable weapons early on, so I spend it earlier than I should be. But that's because the game lets you. So I'll get everybody a Killer Lance, you know, by a certain chapter, which wipes my money out. And that's when I'm like, oh, I'm having a money problem, but it picks back up, though. You know, but in all these other Fire Emblem games that are more linear, I've not really had a money problem in any of them. Can? At all. Yeah, that's the thing. It's all about the forging, dude. If you do forge, you have a money problem. You know, of course. You know what I mean? So that's why you really, like, being knowledgeable in the game in terms of, like, what you need to forge and when you need to forge it is really, like, what makes this game easy, in a sense. People that know exactly what they need and when they need it. You know what I mean? It's like, you know. So for the last four chapters, honestly, all you need is this Forged Brave Lance, plus five. You know? Plus five Forged Brave Lance. And I made a plus seven Dragon Pike. And it wasn't enough to one-shot one of the dragons, though, but it was enough to at least have somebody else kill them. And then we managed to scrape a bit of money to put a plus three on the Brave Bow there or something. Which just let us kill. You know? So all we needed was worms. Like, at the end, all you needed was the Worm Slayers, a Brave Lance, Gradvius. You know, you just need the big dog weapons. You know, that's all you need. You might as well sell all your silver nonsense. And so people who know that off by heart in the early and mid game will be loving it, because in the beginning all you need is like a forged bow to pass the dragon knight levels. Do you know what I mean? And then, like, you can sell all the other BS that you get and have a forged worm slayer for the likes of chapter 12 if you want to do it like that, or something like a forged hand axe there would really be good, actually, because I just done it with like a normal hand axe. So if somebody had a forged hand axe, you know, it'd be fucking GG, you know. Yeah, but it's all about knowing what to forge and when to forge it. So, like, it would be really, really worthwhile. If anybody was going to, like, write a guide for these games, that would be, like, the kind of stuff, information that's valuable. Do you know what I mean? It's like, save up your money for chapter whatever, and you should make a thing we hear, and use this as your main weapon to get by these three chapters. That's the kind of information people should be writing. You know what I mean? Because that's all you really need. I think it's just all about having the right forge at the right time, you know. That's why, like, so some people advised a Rider's Bane for chapter 19, was it? Rider's Banes cost too much money to forge, but just having like a plus 3 poleaxe was enough to kill all the paladins there, and it was only like 4 grand or something, you know. That's what I mean. It just made that level incredibly simplistic, because it one-shot them for a plus 3 poleaxe, you know, instead of a plus 7 Rider's Bane, which was what was needed. You know, fuck. But I tell you, if I did do a new playthrough, it'd be incredibly easier, because I would know the answers for the levels. I would know where to stand and what to do, which I didn't know the first time playing it, and that's what took so long. I started up like chapter 1 right now, I'd know where to go and what to do. It's half the reason why I'm uploading this playthrough to YouTube, is for knowledge for myself, for when I, like, do Lunatic again and stuff. I know what to do just by looking at my own video, because that's the highlighted parts that I'm putting in. You know what I mean? It's actually for me that... I think it's worth, because your main guy is more than likely going to be a dragon, a Draco Knight. And he learns axes. And because he's the main guy who's pretty buff, he gets his axe rank up pretty quick. And then, like I say, with Lunatic Reverse changing the classes, I think being a Berserker late game for him is incredibly good because you get 28 speed and 30 fucking strength. And 30 defense as well, I think. And he's doubling Berserker. So getting your axe rank up on Looney Bin Reverse with a main character is... It happens with my guy naturally, though, being a Draco Knight. But you'd want to make more doubly so, because I feel like Berserker would be the best. Because you'd have a 9-move Berserker with a main character as well. So. And you'd be doubling a lot of enemies that he couldn't double as a Draco Knight. Berserker late game for the win. Paladin pretty good there too, much better than a Draco Knight. Still, the low speed cap is it? The low speed cap just stopped him from being doubled when he would have been doubled as a Draco Knight. You know? Yeah, axe rank for the win though, for the main character. Big time. And I would use the class changing for Lunatic Reverse because I feel like the game's rewarding us for beating normal Lunatic with that class changing A and B thing. It feels like it's meant to be used for Lunatic Reverse. If I ever did normal Lunatic again, though, I wouldn't use it because I feel like that would be a rule for myself because I've done it without it before. And that because I feel like it would have been so much easier if we could have just changed somebody's class to be like a Hunter. Instead of having a rage drog up from the ground, we could have just made like the likes of Ryan one or something. Or even someone like fucking Luke, who is the best one, who would been raising already. You know what I mean? It really just feels like, yeah. It's unlocked for Lunatic Reverse. That's what it feels like. To me. Plainly, because we can't bloody use it on this playthrough. That's what I mean. No, off the bat. I don't... Goth, like, the way I look at it, honestly, and I don't know how people could argue it, is like, I don't think it's intended for normal Lunatic. I don't think it's intended for normal Lunatic because I don't have it. Playing the game for the first time ever, and I choose Lunatic. The way the games have to work is like if they let you choose a difficulty right off the bat, they intend blind players to play that difficulty for the first time ever. You know what I mean? And do that one first. So it has to be balanced around that. You know what I mean? It has to be. It's like FE6. You can't play hard mode without playing normal mode first. Hard mode's not intended to be played before normal. That is the reason right there. Because you have to unlock hard mode to even move, you know. Like Lunatic Reverse, you can't play that blind. They don't want you to. You know what I mean? They don't want that to be your first playthrough. But I cannot, like, sit here and agree that they intend you to use that on normal Lunatic just because you beat it on hard. Because you could choose Lunatic on a fresh file and you don't get it. You know? I have to, and I think it's as clear as that, you know, and I think it's unlocked and intended to be used on Lunatic Reverse only, if I had to say, because that's the way the game works when you turn it on for the first time ever, you know what I mean? I just, obviously 90% of people didn't do it that way though, because they probably just played hard first, which is completely understandable, but as somebody who just turns on the game and decides Lunatic's going to be their first playthrough, we don't get that mechanic because they don't want us to have it. You know what I mean, though, eh? I can't see any argument for it. I think it's in Lunatic Reverse because it's less tested. You know what I mean? And that's it. I think it's allowed to be used in Lunatic Reverse because the mode was no as tested as normal Lunatic. But they allow people to take it just to have an easier time in the other modes. You know? But like I say, if you do Lunatic first, you're not getting it, no matter what. So I can't see how it would be intended to be used on normal Lunatic. But I can't believe you're arguing over one simple fact, though, Goth. That's what gets me. You know? Like, that they never balance the game around you playing Lunatic blind. I don't know how you could say that. Because the game lets you do it. Like, the proof is there if you believe your own eyes. You know? And what's another thing? They didn't let you use the mixed classes in it. So I reckon how you could argue it, really. But obviously you can. because you're trying to build a case. But I'm going to agree to disagree, and I can't be bothered. I can't be bothered anymore. I want to watch the ending. You see my rank, mate? I'll take a normal ranking or something for average bear. I got an E in speed, though. E survival and tactics, though. I'll take that. What's that, then? Mixed bag, then? Look at my tactics. Know what I mean? A for awesome. Ken? Your skills are truly sublime. It's not over yet, though. The lunatic reverse is calling out for you. Yeah, I'm actually pretty pretty surprised I would get an A for tactics, dude. I reckon what that means, though. Because speed's turn count. And I knew it was terrible for that. Because I honestly took like 80 turns on some levels. So we could get actual XP. Speed is never my number one concern. I always will and accept bullshit on that. Survival's always going to be an A. Because we don't let anybody die, I don't think. And even if somebody does die, the game doesn't punish you for it. But I don't know what tactics is. Like, I don't know what actually it's judging me on there. I don't know. I think there will be S ranks, aye? Yeah. It's a shame you don't get an overall rank. Like, if they gave me a C or something. Do you know what I mean? Overall C kind of thing. I would say so. Probably because A, B, C. Like, C's two away from A. And C's two away from E as well. Call it down the middle. Overall C. Enemies are no stronger than Looney Bin mode, but always strike first. Why didn't I just say it got advantage? Yeah, but so if I did get an A in speed, I would have got an overall S. I guess would that be? I don't know. Cause you know I've just got an. Wait a minute. How would you get an S in survival over A? Aye, true that. Actually, true that. Correct. I agree. Well, I just want to take this moment to do a shout out to any of the dudes who watched this playthrough while being in the Twitch or watching any of the episodes on the YouTubes. Just going to say right now, I also want to give a thanks to the people who translated this version of the game for making me find one of my, if not my favourite Fire Emblem game to date. And it's because of you dudes who done the translation that I was able to enjoy this game. So, I really appreciate it. You know? And I'm pretty happy that we actually beat Lunatic Blind. Everything about it was awesome. There was ups and downs. Stress. But fuck, dude. The gameplay of this game is incredible. You know? And I'll be back for Lunatic Reverse. I always like leaving something left to do, you know? I'm okay with that, you know? But yeah, cheers to anybody who watched. You know, maybe we'll tackle another Fire Emblem game like Conquest or something. Lunatic. Some of that. Anyway, cheers to anybody who watched.